Alright guys, today we're actually just doing some power pulls on this yellow Mustang. It's kind of a before and after deal. The work's being done by another shop, but we're going to do some before testing. Just make basically three hits, get the average, and then send it off to those guys. And then when it comes back here, we'll tune it and see what the improvements are numbers wise. So we're just going to make some power hits. So check it out. So like I said, we're doing some power hits on this thing today. First off, before I go through the list of stuff that's already done to this car is gorgeous. I work on a bunch of two-valve Mustangs. I mean, a fair amount. We probably dyno, I don't know, 30, 40 a year. And this is, I mean, by far one of the cleanest ones I've seen. It's just gorgeous. It's gorgeous everywhere, too. Check out the interior. I mean, it's spotless. It's a leather interior, stick shift car. It's got 327s in the back right now for gears. Shut the door real fast. I don't have to listen to the dinger. I got a mod list here. It's got a Saleen Series 4 blower with a 3.5-inch pulley. Just 30-pound injectors currently. Obviously, pump gas stuff. It's got a Bassani off-road X-pipe, Flowmaster 40s. It's got a JLT airbox built for the Saleen blower. And just the factory gear ratio in the back to 327s. So this is gonna get a handful of things done to it once it leaves here before it comes back. Some of those things, including being a 2.8 pulley rather than a 3.5. Some intercooler changes, a bigger throttle body, different mass air, some 47-pound injectors, different camshafts, fuel pump stuff, and some 373. So it's getting a pretty good laundry list of stuff before we see this thing again. It is a 4.6 two-valve car, so yeah, I'm excited to see what this thing's gonna make for power. I'm gonna just jump right into this. I've already got it warm, and basically how I do these before and afters is we're gonna make three hits with a little cool down session between the three, between each hit, and take the average of those three as our before numbers. So I'm gonna get to work on that. All right guys, just wrapped up with those three hits. The first one did pretty good. It made 320, 312. The torque number stayed the same the rest of the time. The horsepower number, this was the second one here. These are in reverse order, obviously, from what they're labeled. I mean, 303 and then 307. The graphs followed each other like pretty much identically every time. I'm gonna just lay that little out there number, that 320 number, over the other two just based on IET. That was the first hit. This isn't air to water intercooled deal, and they don't typically I'm assuming the water temp just got warm after the first hit. I let them cool off 8 minutes between each hit, and I don't think that's enough time to return the IET back to the ambient temp that it was when it got here. So I'm gonna lay that power difference onto that. But 320 wheel, not bad for this thing. These things NA stock make about 100 horsepower, less than that. So be curious to see. I know I've talked to this guy and I can't remember what his power goals are for the upgrades here, but yeah, now we've got a baseline, so we'll see how that pans out when it comes back.